Hello everyone, welcome to this new video. I will show you how to create an invoice report based on Invoice ID using the Report Designer. This process will be the same for both web and desktop Report Designer. In this video, I am going to use the Web Report Designer from the Report Server. First, let me create a new report and name it Invoice Report. Here, I will create an invoice report based on the invoice ID or order ID and provide it as input to the report. For that, I need to create a parameter. Click the parameter in the right navigation bar and create a new parameter. In the panel, I provide the name as invoice ID and the prompt as invoice ID. The value in the prompt field will be displayed in the parameter panel when previewing the report. Next, I click Assign Values. It opens the parameter dialog where I assign a default ID so that the report will automatically be generated with the default ID when previewing. For that, click the default value in the top panel. Select the Specify Value option and add a field to enter the value. Here, I specify it as 10252 and click the OK button. Then click the Save button. Now, the parameter is created. Next, I need to create the required dataset for adding data to the report. I am going to use the existing Northwind database. For that, I create a new data source. Since I have the Northwind database in the SQL server, I select Microsoft SQL Data Connector. You can use your own database. Here, change the name to Northwind and open the Advanced Options pane. In the Connection String field, enter the value. Since I have entered the database credentials in the connection string, I choose the authentication type as None. Click the Connect button. It will open the Query Designer. I change the name to Shipment Details and enable the code which allows the Query Designer pane to enter the SQL query. I enter the SQL query to retrieve the shipment details based on the selected parameter value, which I have already added in the report. And click the Finish button. You will see the Shipment Details dataset created. In the same way, create a dataset for Order Details to retrieve it based on the selected parameter value. Next, to calculate the discount amount and the total price for items based on the quantity and discount percentage, I open the Fields dialog. Add the calculated fields to the new fields. In the field name, enter the value as discount amount. Then, I click the icon next to the field source field and select the expression option. In the expression dialog, enter the expression to calculate the discount amount based on the discount, quantity, and unit price field value. And click the OK button. In the same way, add the calculated field to the price field. Then click the OK button to save. When you expand the Order Details dataset, you will see the calculated fields added. Now, the required datasets are created. Next, to change the width and size of the report design area, I click on the design area and click Properties in the left navigation bar. Under the Position category, change the width to 744 pixels. And the height to 431 pixels. Next, I need to add the header section. I enable header under the view option. I drag and drop a rectangle report item. Once the report item is added, the properties will be displayed. I resize it based on the requirement. In the property panel, change the background color to dark gray. Then, add a text box inside the rectangle and enter invoice. Next, select the text box. In the Property panel under the Basic Settings category, change the font color to white. Size to 18.667. And weight to bold. Under the Text Alignment category, change the vertical alignment to middle. Resize the text box and rectangle based on the requirement. Now, the header section has been added. Next, in the body section, I need to display the shipment and order details based on the selected invoice ID. First, I add a text box. Enter the value as order ID. And resize the text box. Next, I add another text box. Then open the expression dialog for it. And enter the expression to display the order ID with hashtag. And click the OK button. Next, select the order ID text box. And then the value text box. Click the left align option in the toolbar. This will align the text boxes based on the least left value. Next, click the sizing option. And select the same size option. This will change the width and height of the selected report item based on the first report item chosen. Change the font family to Sego UI. And the vertical alignment property to middle. Next, I select the name text box. And change the font color to light gray. Select the value text box. And change the font weight to bold. In the same way, I add the order date name and shipping date and format it. Next, I add the line report item, which acts as a separator for two sections. I resize the line based on my requirement. And I change the color to light gray. Next, to show the billing address, I add a rectangle, which acts as a container for the text boxes. I add a text box inside the rectangle. Add the text, billing address. And resize it. Next, change the font family to Sego UI. Font color to light gray. And the vertical alignment property to middle. Next, add another text box inside the rectangle. And resize it. In the text box's expression dialog, enter the expression to display the billing name. And click OK. In the same way, enter the expression for displaying the address. City. Country. And postal code. Select the text box. And change the font family to Sego UI. Now, select the name. And change the font weight to bold. Next, I add the line report item. And format it. Like the billing address, I add the rectangle for the shipment address. And then add a text box to add the text as shipment address. And format it. I add another text box. And resize it. And add the expressions to display the shipment name. Address, city, country, and postal code. Change the font family to Sego UI. Select the name, and change the font weight to bold. Now, the billing and shipment addresses are added. Next, I want to add the shipment details to a table. For that, first, add a table. And the required columns. Then, add the header as ship name in the first column. In the same way, add the remaining headers, ship address, freight, shipping date, ship city, and ship country. To assign values to the value row, I select a cell. Click the icon next to the content option and select expression. In the expression dialog, enter the expression that displays the ship name and click OK. Now, the value is assigned to the cell. In the same way, add values to the rest of the cells. The currency value needs to be displayed in the currency format. I select the freight value cell and change the format to currency with 2 decimal points. Then, change the shipping date format to date. To format the header row, select the header row and change the font family to Sego UI. Font weight to bold. Under alignment, text alignment to center and vertical alignment to middle. Under appearance, change the background color to light gray. Then select the value row and change the family to Sego UI. Under alignment, text alignment to center and vertical alignment to middle. In the same way, add another table. And assign values to the table so that it displays order details. And format the table. Then select the unit price and price cell and change the format to currency with 2 decimal values. Then select the discount value cell and change the format to percentage with 0 decimal values. The next step is to calculate the sum of the price. I add a new row using outside group below, which adds a new row at the end of the table when previewing the report. Then, merge the cells other than the price cell into one and enter the value as total in the content property. Select the price value cell. Find the sum of the price value and change the format to currency with 2 decimal values. Format the row by changing the font weight, alignments, and background color. Then I add a text box below the table for declaration. And add the content as I or we hereby certify that the information on this invoice is true and correct and that the contents of this shipment are as stated above. And format it. Next, add a text box below the declaration. Add the text as signature of the authorized person. And format it. Now, everything is ready to preview the report. Click the preview button. See, the invoice is displayed with the default parameter. You can also view the invoice based on the available invoice ID in the database. For that, I move to design mode. Create a new dataset and name it Invoice Details with the existing Northwind data source. In the Query Designer, enter the SQL query, which retrieves all the order IDs from the database, and click Finish to save it. Open the Parameter panel and edit the Invoice ID parameter. Click click Assign Values. And then select Query in the Available Values section. Choose Invoice Details from the Dataset dropdown. And Order ID for Value and Label fields. And click OK. Next, click the Save button in the Parameter panel. Now, preview the report. And open the Report Parameters section. Here, you will see the available parameters. Select any one. And click the View Report button. The invoice report will be generated based on the selected parameter value. In this video, I have shown you how to create an invoice report based on the selected invoice ID. I have also added a downloadable link for the report in the video's description. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.